that. This son was my elder brother. They took him and laid him down. They cut his head off while his father was watching. Not one Muslim man was left. They were imprisoned and killed. Children were boiled in water. They said, "We are serving you lamb," and made women eat their husbands. Even Russian commanders reacted to the massacres committed by the Armenians. A cable message dated January 29, 1915, which was preserved in the Russian National Communist Party Central Committee, and which was discovered a short time ago in the classified archives, tells about the actions of Armenian rebels. The reports received by the 1st Caucasian Army Commander reveal that some Armenian rebels active in the region have gone to cities and settlements and established themselves at households there. They refused to abide by the orders of the castle commander. The undisciplined and immoral doings of these teams have reached such an extent that they are subjecting the civilians to violence, Colonel Yakovlev.
Whatever the condition was, following the takeover of Van, local Turks were killed. There were robberies and rapes. The Russian army that came to the region later on encountered with a city that was taken over. Russian commanders witnessed incidents of rape, robbery, and murder there. Documents pertaining to these are available at the History of War Museum.
They put everyone on ships and took them to the islands, to Ekdamar, Çarpanak, and Adair Island. They killed them all and threw the bodies into the water. They disposed of the bodies in the water.
The Ottoman Empire Sultan Mehmet II, the conqueror, had granted tax exemption to churches. Numerous Armenians had served in the Ottoman bureaucracy. In the National Statement for Armenians by the Ottoman Empire, their rights and freedoms were guaranteed. Archive documents reveal that the Armenian nation, along with the other ethnic and religious groups, was granted privileges, and they served at the highest ranks of the state hierarchy and lived freely in peace.
The Ottoman Empire would not have lasted for 600 years. You can't for 600 years suppress, subdue, or bully a lot of people of different ethnic groups. In any case, if you ill-treat your subjects, then the tax is not collected from them.
This all shows that the Ottoman Empire felt trust and good intentions toward the Armenians under Ottoman rule, even after the Christian communities in the Balkans sought independence one by one.
Güven hissetmektedirler.
The system of the Ottoman Empire was based on tolerance, and she had the best record of the period. Experts point out to this fact. The following words of Mahmud II are important in the sense that they indicate the basic philosophy of the Turkish state system. "I can only differentiate the Muslims of my subjects at mosque, the Christians at church, and the Jewish at synagogue. Apart from that, they are all my sons and daughters." The administration would view the different religions of its citizens only at their sacred places. Besides that, they were all considered equal.
Bu dönemde, bu süreç içinde biz Ermenilerden de hiçbir
Within this period, not a word nor a whisper was heard from the Armenians regarding independence or autonomy. On the contrary, they were serving in very important positions of the state apparatus. Because of this, even after the Greeks won their independence, after the 1820s, we see Armenian officers as the only Christian elements in the Turkish army, and they are called the faithful nation.
Şimdi sorulması gereken soru şudur. Niçin?
The question that must be asked now is why two nations that lived in peace for 800 years started to fight in such a way. The Armenian nationalists say the Turks had always suppressed us. Why would a nation who had not suppressed Armenians for 800 years all of a sudden start to suppress them at the end of the 19th century? Of course, that is not true in any way. The incidents of the late 19th century are the consequences of the emergence of Armenian nationalism.
The Ottoman Empire's offer of refuge to the persecuted Jews in Spain. For Americans, the year 1492 is a year of discovery, of new beginnings. However, 1492 was a gloomy time in Europe. In that year came the expulsion of Spain's large Jewish community. In a time when in Western Europe religious tolerance was all too rare, the Ottoman Empire extended the hand of friendship to a persecuted minority of a faith and culture different from its own.
Anatolia is the cradle of freedom of faith. The oldest synagogue in Bursa is an indicator of the tolerance of Sultan Orhan Gazi toward the Jewish and other communities in the establishment period of the Ottoman Empire. The Jewish star decorations on the ironworks of the Great Mosque are a documentation of being far away from religious bigotry.
I always ask the same question to my students. Have you ever thought about the fact that Turkish is not spoken anymore in the Balkans, Northern Africa, or Caucasia, where the Ottoman Empire ruled for over five or six centuries? It is very important, in my view, that the Ottomans did not impose the Turkish language or Turkish rule. Greek, Serbian, Arabic, and Slavic languages, as well as Italian, were freely spoken.
Various documents are available in the British public records on the uprisings of Armenians against the Ottoman Empire. These documents reveal how these separatist movements were used by the imperialist powers of the period. The record number 22083, dated February 23, 1915, is a report sent by their embassy to Foreign Minister Sazonov. The report recounts Russians arming Armenians against Turks in the eastern provinces of Turkey. The record number 25167, dated March 4, 1915, is a cable message from Bulgaria. Mr. Varadian from the Armenian Committee in Bulgaria seeks help from Britain to transfer 20,000 Armenian volunteers to Iskenderun. Varadian informs that 10,000 Armenians are also waiting in the US to fight against the Ottoman state. Another correspondence in the British Foreign Affairs Archives informs that Armenian volunteers are ready to participate in the uprising in Kilikia.
Of course, some states worked on the Turkish-Armenian relations, and Russia, the USA, France, Britain, and China had